Hey guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to add a fully functional contact form to your Streamlit application. This contact form comes already with form validation. For instance, you cannot send the message if you do not fill out all the required fields or if you provide an incorrect email format. I will also show you how you can easily add more fields and customize the contact form to your needs and liking. But for now, let me go ahead and type a name, email and message here. After clicking the button, we will be redirected to the default success page. You can also change the redirection to any other page. And if I check my email inbox, we will see the message we just have sent. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. I have prepared a simple script which only contains a Streamlit header so far. The web app looks like this. For the contact form, we will be using a free service of Form Submit. I will leave the link to this website also in the description box below. I will copy the starter template from this website, go back to my script and store it in int string. Once done, I will inject the HTML code into our Streamlit app by using a markdown field and setting the unsafe allow HTML parameter to true. Okay, after saving the script and refreshing the web app, we will see our contact form. We will take care of the styling in just a moment, but before that, let me switch back to the script and change the email address. If you try to send an email for the first time, you will get the following message saying that you first need to activate your email address. So let me shortly do that by switching over to my inbox and clicking on the link. Once we've gotten that out of the way, I will submit one more message. This time I will be asked to submit a recapture before sending the message. Later I will also show you how to turn off the recapture validation. With that said, let me go back to my email inbox. And we can see that it worked. I now have received the message. As mentioned already, you can further customize the contact form. All customization options can be found in the documentation of the Form Submit website. You could, for instance, add a subject, CC field, or change the redirection link after you have submitted the form. In my case, I will turn off the recapture validation field. All you need to do is to copy this line here and insert it into your script. Additionally, I will add a placeholder to the name and email field. For the actual message, I will grab the text area field and insert it below the email field. With those changes in place, our contact form will look like this. To put it mildly, it does not look very appealing, but we could customize it with some CSS. Now, I'm not a CSS expert, but on W3 Schools you will find some awesome CSS tutorials and examples. If we look at their contact form example, it is very similar to our current form. Therefore, let me grab the CSS code from here. As we do not have a container class, I will not copy the last part. In the root folder of the current app, I will create a new folder called style. In this new folder, I will create a style.css file. Open up this file with your preferred text editor and paste the CSS code we just have copied. There are only some minor tweaks we need to make. If I place our current script and the CSS code next to each other, we will see what changes we have to make. Instead of the select element, we would like to style our input field with the type email. Okay, and with that change in place, we will now need to find a way to inject this CSS code also in our Streamlit app. As before, we could use a string and a markdown field, but this could look very messy. An alternative and in my opinion much cleaner solution is to define a function that reads in the CSS content and returns it to a markdown field. The HTML style text I use to define the style information, which will be applied to the HTML content of our current Streamlit app. After that, I will call the function and provide the file path to our CSS file. Okay, and with that in place, let me refresh our web app. And I think this looks much better now, but it seems that I forgot to change the CSS code for the button. Instead of an input field, we have used a button. After this quick fix, let me save the CSS file and refresh the page again. Okay, and here's our final contact form. One more time, I will test it out. And as expected, we've got now the new submission in our inbox. Okay guys, and that's it for this tutorial. As always, if you have any questions, please let me know. Thanks for watching and see you next time.